One of Rhode Island Monthly's featured restaurants, Boathouse, is with us today. Chef Max Peterson is here. We're making New England seafood stew.
Yes, sir.
Thanks so much for coming in on this cold morning. It's great to have you here.
Thanks for having us. Appreciate it.
All right. We see the seafood that you have, that you brought in today. When we think a lot of the seafood, a lot of time you think in summer and everything else and what to do. But on a cold day like this, I would imagine a seafood stew, keep it nice and warm and toasty and all good stuff.
Most definitely. We have a lot of ingredients that are nice and hearty, especially for a nice
cold day like today.
Yeah. Most definitely.
Let's go over the ingredients. Tell everybody what they need to make this.
Sure. To start out, we got a lemon sole, which is from the Georges Banks. And we also have a sea scallops, local Rhode Island little necks. And these are Gulf of Mexico shrimp.
Okay.
We need a little bit of fennel, onions, garlic, celery. These are some fingerling potatoes, some crushed tomatoes. Mm-hmm. This is clam juice, a little bit of saffron, which is a big ingredient within this dish, salt, pepper, and cooking oil, and a little bit of Portuguese olive oil.
Nice. Can you give us a little more information about the fish that we're using tonight? Like the flavor, the texture of it? And you said it came from right here in Rhode Island.
Yes. The Georges Banks, which is right off of the Cape, mm-hmm. Where we get... We call this a ground fish,
okay.
Which means that it's local
right.
to the Georges Banks. The sole is a bottom feeding fish. It stays at the bottom, eats a lot of crustaceans, crabs, little necks, and the such. So it's a nice, sweet, rich flavor to
okay.
it. It's kind of flaky, a little bit, not as meaty or flaky as a cod, but it's got a much more buttery, sugary flavor to it. The scallops, kind of the same thing. These are dry pack scallops. They're not touched at all. They're straight out of the water. Mm-hmm. They are as is. And these are great because if you sear them, they get a nice, all the natural sugars come out, and they're a beautiful product.
Good stuff.
Yeah.
All right, we've got all of our ingredients ready to go. Chef's going to be whipping up a stew for us this morning. In the meantime, back to you.
Thanks, Meg. Chef Max from Boathouse joins us. They are featured in this month's issue of Rhode Island Monthly, and we're going to get things started with the dish today, right?
Sure, yeah. You're going to help me out?
Yes.
Excellent.
That's what I'm here for.
We're going to start out by steaming open the little necks.
Okay.
It actually takes a little bit longer than most people think. So, yeah, just put a little bit of the water in.
Okay.
You don't have to cover. Just a little bit to start. And then we'll hit it with a little bit of the Portuguese vino verde, which is a little sparkling light wine.
All right, just say when.
Perfect.
Okay.
And then I cut up some parsley earlier, so we're just going to throw those in for a little aromatics.
Great.
And we're just going to top that out.
Throw it on some high heat.
That's right. Oop, wrong one.
Great.
There you go.
Those will steam up. And you know when those are done because they'll start to open, is that right?
Yep. And then if they don't open, then they're not alive.
Okay.
But the great thing about this, you kind of want to reserve the liquor is what we call it, which is the salt water that is inside of the clam.
Mm-hmm.
And that adds a lot of flavor to the dish. We'll actually add that to the stew, which I'm going to start.
Okay, you have, you're talking about we're going to sweat the vegetables, is that right? What do you mean by that?
We're not
putting them in the gym. We're not like giving them dumbbells, right?
No, we're going to use some extra virgin, Portuguese olive oil.
Okay.
Which is not an extra virgin. It's just it's great for cooking. It's got a great flavor. And when sweating, we're going to, you're going to cook them until they're a little translucent. They're not going to break down so much. They're
okay.
going to hold their body. We're going to get this hot.
This high heat then when
not
we're,
super
we're
it doesn't have to we're not caramelizing so you don't really want to
okay.
You don't want it super hot and you also don't want flare up
gotcha
and
yeah we'd appreciate that
yeah.
No fire flames in the kitchen today
and we always want to season at almost every stage in the cooking you don't want to kill it obviously
mm-hmm.
but at different stages if I add too much salt at the beginning I'll skip a few stages but
okay.
initially you definitely want to you build layers we're going to draw out all the sugars
okay.
in these
and you
onions.
Got some pepper in there too right
yeah a little bit of white pepper we like to use so the white pepper with the fish it's not as astringent as a black pepper which you'd use with beef
well that's a nice cooking tip
yeah most definitely
yeah that's great okay we're going to get sweating those vegetables and we'll tell you more about Boathouse being in Rhode Island Monthly coming up a little later in the show back to you.